Hello everyone and welcome to the CSE and ME guys. So from today we are starting the video series for the examination like the SSC JE, PSU, BARC, ISRO, DRDO and other state level exam in which the question are asked like the objective and most of all them the theoretical questions. So in this video series we will cover all the subject and it's an objective type questions. So today we are going to start with the thermodynamic. So let's start the thermodynamic question number first. The question number first said that for the isothermal expansion of a gas of a perfect gas, the value of enthalpy by P is equals to. So the for the isothermal expansion, the for the perfect gas, the del P by P is equals to the minus of del V by V. So the option number B will be the correct. The next question is the gas load del PV by T is equals to constant is 2,4. So as we know that the gas law said that the PV equals to MRT. So from here we can rewrite the equation PV by T equals to constant. So for the PV by T is equals to constant, it's true for the both the isothermal process and the adiabatic changes. The question number third is the air in a cylinder is suddenly compressed by a piston with the passage of a time. Here we are considering a piston cylinder arrangement. The gas inside the cylinder is compressed by a compression. So as we due to the compression temperature of gas increases very high. Due to the increase of the temperature, the flow of heat will take place from the system to the surrounding, and due to that the temperature decreases, so we can say that the pressure will also decreases. So the option number A will be the correct. The next question number 4, the work done in an adiabatic changes. In the case of the adiabatic process, as we know that the dQ is equals to 0 on a particular gas, so it depend on change in temperature only. The work done in an isothermal expansion of a gas depend on. The work done in an isothermal expansion. Isothermal, as we know that the isothermal temperature is constant, it depends on both the temperature and the expansion ratio. The next question is the first law of a thermodynamics is concerned with the first law of a thermodynamics is concerned with the energy. Here we are considering all the laws. The zeroth law of thermodynamics is all about the temperature and its equilibrium. The first law of thermodynamics is about the energy conservation. So from here we can say that the energy is neither be created nor be destroyed. Then the second law of thermodynamics states the entropy of a system. The next one is the a Carnot engine work between the hot reservoir at the temperature T1 and the cold reservoir at the temperature T2, that is called sink and that is the source. And then is the Carnot engine. The heat flow from higher energy to the lower temperature. So the efficiency of a Carnot engine is given by the 1 minus T2 by T1. So if you want to increase the efficiency, that means we have to decrease the temperature T2 and increase the temperature T1. That means it is the option number D. The next question, question number 8, which of the following is intensive property? So let's understand what is the mean of intensive property. So the intensive property, the property which are independent of mass is called intensive, independent of mass is called the intensive property. So the temperature is independent of mass, so the option number B will be the correct. And the next question, which of the following is the extensive property? So the extensive property is defined as the property which is dependent on the mass, which is dependent on the mass. The property which dependent on the mass is called the extensive property. So the option number B, the volume will depend on the mass, because as we know that the density is equals to So density is equals to mass per unit volume. So volume is equals to density, mass upon density. So the volume is dependent on the mass, so that is called extensive property. The next question is the temperature at which the volume of a gas becomes zero is called the absolute zero temperature. From the definition of the absolute zero temperature, we know that for the ideal gas, the volume of the gas becomes zero at the absolute zero temperature. The unit of the energy in the SI system is, the unit of the energy in the SI system is, SI system ke andar unit kya ho jayegi apni, energy ki unit ho jayegi joule. 1 watt is equals to, so the 1 watt, this is the watt is the unit of the energy, or we can say that the work, and work is defined as the force into displacement, so it can be written as the Newton meter. So the option number A is the correct. The next one is the joule is equals to, 1 joule is equals to, joule is the energy which is also equals to the 1 Newton meter. Energy and work ki unit kya ho jayegi apni same hogi, to option number A will be the correct. The question number 14, the heating and expanding of a gas, the heating and expanding of a gas is called the thermodynamic cycle. The next question is, which of the following statement is correct? So the slope of the vaporization curve is always negative. The second option, the slope of the vaporization curve is always positive. The third option is, the slope of the sublimation curve is negative for all the pure substances. And the fourth one is, the slope of the fusion curve is positive for all the substances. The only the option number A is correct, which is the slope of the vaporization curve is always negative. Next question number 16, the specific volume of a water when heated at the 0 degree centigrade. The specific volume, you know that the specific volume is the volume per unit mass is defined as the specific volume at the 0 degree centigrade. The specific volume first decreases then increases. As we know that at the 0 degree centigrade, the specific volume first decreases then increases. Because as we know that the density is maximum at the 4 degree centigrade for water. From here you can relate, because as the ice melts, it's in a volume or density first decreases then it increases. The next question is the internal energy of a perfect gas depend on the For the perfect gaze, internal energy. It is the property of the system, then it is only dependent on the temperature. The option number D will be the correct. In the reversible polytropic process, for the reversible polytropic process, as we know that the PV to the power n is equals to constant. In the polytropic process, dQ is not equals to 0, but in case of the adiabatic process, the dQ is equals to 0. So here dQ is not equals to 0, so we can say that the true heat transfer occurs in case of the reversible polytropic process. In an isentropic process is always, the isentropic process is also called the isentropic process. Is also called reversible and adiabatic process. Reversible and adiabatic process is called the isentropic process. So the option number D will be the correct. The last one is the second law for thermodynamics defined. The second law for thermodynamics defined the entropy of system. As in earlier we discussed the zeroth law of thermodynamics is about the equilibrium of temperature. The first law of thermodynamics is the conservation of energy. And the second law of thermodynamics is about the entropy of a system. And note down the one special point, which is the entropy of a universe never goes negative. That means the entropy of a universe is always positive or zero. So guys, thank you for watching this video, and further question of the thermodynamics we will take in the next video. For more videos, subscribe our channel.